I visited the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum a few days ago, and if any of you are visiting Boston anytime soon, I would highly recommend going to this museum. I was pretty blown away from not only the architecture, but the amount of detail that went into the curation of every room, each plant, everything. The garden was so beautiful, and I spent a lot of time just exploring the different rooms. I ended up spending a lot of time in the greenhouse, taking a lot of pictures of the different plants they were nurturing there, and I was inspired to draw some of the fun-looking ones. The same day that I went to the museum, I actually got a package from Huon, which included one of their newest tablets that they wanted me to try out. You all probably know that I'm not a huge digital art person yet, but the last tablet that they had sent me, I gave to my brother because he's studying 3D visualization, digital art, he's doing a lot of this kind of research, and I definitely knew that he would have more use for it than I did. And he told me that he loved the tablet, so I was pretty open to trying out the newer ones that they offered to send me. And rather than a review, I think I'm going to tell you about my experience while using it since I'm not a digital artist. Maybe I can offer some sort of different perspective, but I'm mostly just going to be telling you how I thought the tablet worked for my case. First of all, this is not a sponsored video, but Huon did send this tablet to me for free. So I'm going to try to give feedback, taking into account that this is $450, which is a lot of money. So the big question is it worth $450? Well, one of the best things for me is that the tablet is really thin. It's important for me personally because I'm constantly on the move around cities, and I needed something that wouldn't take a lot of space. I also found that the buttons on the tablets were key in my workflow while I was drawing. Normally, I usually don't even bother learning how to use the buttons on the tablets just because I would rather use my keyboard, but I found that the buttons actually help a lot with making the workflow more fluid. I always use the tablet by holding the pen in one hand and having the other hand resting over the button so I can switch commands really easily. In all of the footage I have of me testing out the tablet, I wanted to show myself physically drawing on the tablet rather than a screen recording, just so you could see how the tablet reacts to the pen and how responsive it is. I've given digital art a try before. There's a video on my channel that I used the first tablet that Huon had sent me, but for some reason, this time around, it was a lot easier to get into drawing on the tablet than before. I don't know, and I don't think it's because the tablet was different. I think it's just me being more familiar with digital tablets in general that made it easier. But it also might have been because I was experimenting a lot with the Kyle Webster brushes in Photoshop. But I definitely never felt like the tablet was impeding what I was trying to draw or getting in the way. Long story short, I don't want to talk about the tablet for too long. Ultimately, the tablet is great. I love that they include a stand, and the price point compared to the Cintiq is pretty unbeatable, so I give this a 2 thumbs up. I thought it would be perfect to warm up and get used to drawing on the tablet by sketching the plants that I had seen in the museum. Near the end of the video, I'll show other drawings I did of Chinatown that I also used as an exercise to familiarize myself with the tablet. I'll let the rest of the video play now, but I also wanted to quickly mention that the brushes that I'm using are the Kyle Webster brushes that you can download if you have Adobe Creative Cloud or a subscription to Photoshop. And I mostly used the chalk slash copier brushes, and the program I used was obviously Photoshop. So, all right, that's it for now. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video.